That song has been on repeat for me since New Year's Eve. I'm a bad A woman. Sorry for the children in the room. It's so good though. It's just like that pump you up. And if you're a dude, just like change up the lyrics and then it works for you as well. It's perfect. Good morning, everybody. Happy Saturday. I hope you guys all had an amazing time with your families over the holidays. Hopefully you're feeling good and you're feeling ready to rock. I started kind of doing, I guess, New Year's resolutions, you can call it, in November. So I'm like rolling into 2021, like ready for it. I got up before the kids this morning. I'm feeling good. And I'm so excited to share with you guys some things that I have learned over the last few months. And some of the things I've been doing in my business this whole time, but like, I didn't really know I was doing it until someone put it so eloquently for me. So I'm really, really excited to share that. So for those who don't know me, my name is Gloria McLean. I'm a platinum leader with Young Living, and I have been on this journey for just over 4 years now. It is the best journey ever. It has been so much fun. And more than ever, I say this on every call because I mean it so much, is that the community is like the biggest blessing ever. So if you have that starter kit and you're on this call, just know you've already won. You're already winning. So there you go. Okay. So today I'm going to talk to you guys about simplicity and actually being productive versus doing busy work. Okay. How many people feel like they just like do things all the time, but they're not really maybe getting where they want to be, and they feel like they're just so busy. Okay. So perfect. No, that's good, because today we're going to really, really simplify. So I heard this line, I shared it in my group yesterday, and it said, be like the postage stamp, stick to the one thing until you get there. How good is that, right? It's just, it comes down to one thing. And in this business, that one thing is inviting new people to take a look. That's it. If you're not doing that one thing and you're keeping busy doing all the other things that you think it takes, you're missing the point, and your focus is too big. People think success is like adding more to their calendar, being busier. Like, they don't even have a space in their day. Being productive means like go, go, go all day long. But that's not it. The most productive people say no to the things that don't matter, and they keep their focus on the main thing. They keep the main thing the main thing. They don't overexert themselves because they have their calendar booked for the month at the beginning of the month, right? So therefore, they're not saying yes to all these things because they're keeping that main thing the main thing. So if you feel like your focus has been too big and you're feeling overwhelmed, I invite you today to just like shrink your focus back, put those blinders on right now, and we're going to keep the main thing the main thing. So these girls today are going to like share with you how we do that. But so how I've done it and what I was taught and trained, and it has worked absolutely 100%, is that I have focused solely on doing one-on-one classes. I don't teach other classes because the main thing I'm focusing on is bringing in new members to take a look at the product and the opportunity. And the one-on-one does just that. It keeps the focus on the fire, on the bringing in new people, which lights the fire up our whole organization. And if we stray from that, then we're going to see like in our business, or like, right? And so the good thing is if you're like, oh my gosh, I have been not focusing, Gloria, on the main thing. I have been like off in la la land. I've been trying to drag people. I've been trying to build other people's businesses for them, but I haven't been inviting myself, and I haven't been doing my own classes. And like, I've been all, the good news is right now we can change that. Okay. And we can get back to focusing. So that's why the one-on-ones are so effective. And that's why, listen to the advice that you're going to hear from everyone today. And I just also wanted to share the domino effect with you guys. So when we simplify and we keep our focus on one thing, it's like lining up a domino. Okay. If you have a little tiny domino, it can't take out like a really big domino right away, right? It doesn't work that way. But if you like stack it up and you get consistent and you keep them all just lining up, that little tiny domino, when you push it, it's going to go do, 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 do. And then it can take down the most like monstrous domino at the end, right? You can't just like start by hitting out the big things and like thinking too big. You got to start small. It's all about these like little daily actions that we do. And they don't seem like massive, but you're not leaping to your dreams. You're like building like a little domino set. Okay. Just like little daily actions that we're going to line up over years that take time. But then when we knock them down, we're going to like have huge, huge success. So people get focused on too many things and that's how they get distracted. So don't focus big. You want to go small. So we're going to get back to the basics. And that's why I'm so excited about this call today. So keeping the main thing, and this is to avoid burnout because I don't want you guys to burn out. I don't want you guys to be like going 15 hours a day. Like that's ridiculous. You're going to hate this. You're going to burn out. You're going to be like, I don't even know. I have no one left to talk to. I'm burnt out. I've tried everything except you didn't like keep that focus. You didn't plan the calendar. You didn't treat it like a business. Okay. It's just like, we're just trying to throw like all the stuff at the wall and see what sticks, but we know what works. There's a system and it works. And these ladies again are going to go over that. So don't burn yourself out. I don't want that for you. Being productive actually means that you schedule your downtime just as much as you schedule the time that you're going to work. Okay. So make sure that you also schedule time with the family, time with the spouse, time to like go for your walks or get out in nature. That is just as important to be a healthy, happy, productive human being. So extraordinary results is when we narrow our focus down and we say no to anything that isn't actually building our business. Okay. People think it's the opposite. They think that success means to like fill their calendars and to-do lists, which I talked about, but they are not prioritizing the things that are truly building success. Success comes from doing a few things really well. Okay. You get really, really good at doing one-on-ones and following up and inviting if that's what you're sticking to. You get really, really good at it. And you get really good at like knocking objections out of the park because you've done it and you're confident in your skills because you've kept that like main thing, the main thing as well. So do not spread yourself thin. You need to subtract and not add. So if you're doing too many things, you need to like subtract all that stuff, get clear, get focused. 2021, I know 2020 was supposed to be the year of like perfect vision. Forget that. It's 2021. We're making new rules. So this is the year of getting clear and keeping the main thing, the main thing. So if at the end of the day, you're like, I didn't ask a single person today to take a look at, sorry, Kayla. But if you didn't ask a single person to come to a class or to take a look at the opportunity or like message somebody about like, I had a girl the other day say on New Year's Eve, she made a post about how the masks she has to wear at work are making her break out. I sent her a private message. Hey, I've got lavender. It really helped clear my skin. I would love to send you a sample. She goes, you know what? I think I'm ready to get a kit. I've been watching you. I got to sign up on New Year's Eve. See that opportunity and freaking go for it. And not on their public wall because then the vultures will come out and attack. Go into a private message, folks. Another wise word of advice, go to that private message. But you have to every day, even on New Year's Eve. Yes, on New Year's Eve. Even on my birthday. Yes, on your birthday. Did you ask somebody to take a look at the opportunity or the products? And if you haven't done that and you've been like, I've been so busy, but you haven't done that thing, we need to get back to the main thing. Am I getting clear yet? Main thing, main thing, main thing. Okay. So simplicity is the key to success. If you're doing too much, people are going to look at what you're doing and be like, I don't want that life. She looks exhausted. Or he, they look like they have to do like 15 classes a week and like all these things that I don't have time for that. Right. But if we're like, oh girl, I do one class or maybe two classes a week. I fit this in the cracks of my life. Like it is so simple. I use my productive time to like really just get it done in the morning for me, but some people come alive at night. Good for you. Not me. I have a toddler. That is not my time to shine. In the morning, I get my stuff done and then I'm done for the day. I've done it. I've invited. I've booked the class. I've like followed up with my people before 10 a.m. So I'm like, I'm good. I got this. And then I have my day to enjoy and people see me living my life. And that's what attracts them to what I'm doing. If I just look like I'm doing Young Living all the time on my social media, people are like, I don't want that. So simplicity is the key. And it comes even down to like explaining essential rewards. If you overcomplicate essential rewards, how many people have overcomplicated it? And then you see people go, I don't want that. Right? Or how many times did you fire hose someone when they asked you about Young Living? You got like way too excited and you were like, here's all the things and here's 10 videos to watch. And like, oh my God, it's going to change your life. And they're like, witness protection program. Okay. Yeah, I've done it too, guys. So it's okay. You're not alone. But what I'm saying is simplicity wins the day in every single area. We overcomplicate things. It does not need to be that way. Okay. Even when it comes to like getting fit, people are like, oh, it's so hard. I'm like, really? It's just eating healthy and moving your body every day. It's really not hard, but we like make it so hard. Right. And it's the same in this business. It's not hard. We just like, we maybe made it complicated in our own head. So we just need to get back. So keep your blinders on to the main thing. In this business also, I just wanted to say that it's also like 80-20. So the 80-20 rule is 80% of your time should be building your business, your own business, not your team's businesses. Because I see people fall into management mode where they're not doing the things and they're just like trying to drag people over here and inspire people over here and like keep, right? Who's been guilty of that? I've been guilty of that. I've gotten into that trap. And what happened for me is I stopped enrolling people, right? I mean, it happens. We're human and it might happen again, even after you hear this call today, but it's just that awareness of going, okay, I've made things too complicated again. I'm spending 80% of my time managing my team and I'm not doing the things I need to do to continue to grow my business, which by the way, it may seem selfish, but when you pour that 80% onto yourself and keeping your blinders on and your team sees you ranking up, guess what happens automatically to your team? They're inspired and they're rising up with you. So it's not selfish, it's necessary, okay? So if you feel like, oh, 80% of my time is going to my team right now and I'm not doing the things that I know I should be doing for my own business, again, bring that focus in. So I just wanted to share with you guys before I let you go here, my new board. Oh my gosh, you guys, by the way, I'm totally wearing like pajama pants right now. So. You're welcome. So, okay, my ring light's gonna show here. I don't know if you can see. Anyways, you don't have to like fully read it, but this is my big whiteboard that I have on my wall. So here are the people I need to follow up with that are my new members so that they don't ever get that second kit sent to them. And I have like made sure I'm following up, I'm talking, I'm sharing the excitement of the business. I'm like making sure they're seeing the videos. They are like right there. Here's my daily dozen of things that I do every day, even on your birthday, every day. So I have like encourage, team, invite, go in your virtual office, plant new seeds, meditate, pray, breathwork, nature, water, exercise, okay, up before the kids. So it doesn't just have to be business. But I know these are the things that are going to make me productive and happy and a better leader. And if I just do all work, I'm going to show up in front of you guys like, huh, I have nothing left to give. And that's not fair to you or me. So RCD, 80-20, Gloria, stop putting 80 to 90% like dragging or managing. Okay. It's like, that is the main thing, the main thing. Top priorities for the day. Okay. Like, and sometimes it's get your dang laundry done, Gloria. It doesn't have to just be business, but these are the things you need to do to be a productive human. My goals for January. And then I got team goals, which I erased because I didn't want to show everybody's like names and stuff on here, but I'm going to put back up. I wrote it on a paper. Okay. And then that sits on my wall where I can see it every single day. Because when I didn't do that, how easy is it to get super distracted. And at the end of the day, you're like, oh my gosh, I didn't call the dentist. And like, dang, I had to do that thing. Or right. Or I didn't check that school email, or I didn't like, it doesn't, again, have to be business, but what are those burning priorities that you have to get done that are time sensitive? Cause those should be at the top of your list. And anything else that doesn't fit in that, like, why are you doing all this busy work that isn't actually the things that you need to get done? If you have to follow up with those three people, just knock it out of the park. Right away, get it off your plate. We spend so much time thinking about doing the dang thing instead of just doing it. It's actually worse to like let it sit in there and fester, right? You feel me? How many people let it sit in there and fester? You're like, Gloria, just do the thing, like, or whoever, like, do it, just do it, like, just do it. Like Nike said, or Shia LaBeouf, do it. Has anyone seen that? No. You just like get it done, get it knocked out of the park, and like get those blinders on. Get like your main priorities. And like, I think it was the hyperconscious guys that said, like, write down the five things you know you need to do and then circle like the three that you need to get done in the morning. Like, these are my main three, and you shouldn't do anything else. I don't care if your house is a mess. I don't care, like, whatever else isn't done. You do those three things first, and then you organize your cupboards, and then you like go fold your laundry, and then you go and do whatever else you had to do. But trust me, your life is going to change when you just like knock those things off your list as soon as possible. You're going to feel free. You're going to feel not so overwhelmed. You're going to feel like I'm doing the things I know I need to do. Okay. And then you're going to win. And I want that for you. So sorry, I got a little red on you guys today, but it's because I love you. Okay. Up next, we have Miranda Brown. She is a gold leader and she is going to come and give you some awesome tips on like equipping and enrolling and all the good things. So hi, Miranda.
Hey guys. Okay, this actually is going to go really nicely along with what Gloria just opened with. This is really simple. And this is where we need to start for January, because it is simple and we forget that it is actually just simple, simple, simple. So it's three things we're going to talk about: is enrolling, educating, and empowering. And if we can keep it at those three things, amazing things start to happen. So the number one thing that is our job is to help people get started. All of us here, no matter how long we have been doing this, our goal needs to be a minimum of 2 enrollments a month. Because if we are not enrolling, our team doesn't do the things. They need to see us doing the things. So minimum goal, 2 enrollments a month. I don't care what rank you are, you keep looking for that and enrolling the people. Classes. So, and we're all well aware, classes are on Zoom now, and there is tons of opportunity, tons. You just need to look to your upline, ask where the classes are, create your own if you want. I tell people just invite and get people into the Zooms. So at least a minimum of 1 Zoom a week that you're inviting to. But you need, just like enrolling, you need to be inviting. You can't rely on your downline and team to do all that for you. You need to be doing that. Doing like unboxing videos, whatever that looks like, you need to be sharing your excitement because this is what's going to help other people. Like Gloria said, when she private messaged and said, hey, I have lavender and this really worked. That's showing she's using the products and getting people excited because she's still showing her excitement for it. And checking your VO every single day is really important. You cannot grow this business without being in there and knowing how it works. And if you need help, you need to just ask because there are so many amazing things in there that can grow your business just by knowing how to navigate that space. And then the next thing is educate. So once you've got your members and you've growing a team, you need to educate them and teach them how to educate themselves. So this can be a continual conversation of sharing a tidbit of information, sharing what's working for you, making sure your team knows the monthly promos. Like, this is really basic stuff, but I am amazed sometimes when I've reached out and people don't know the promos yet. So it's really important that basic stuff is happening. Edify your leaders. This shows the people that they are enrolling that they have done something, and everybody in the world wants to be seen, everybody. So if you are showing up in that way for your people and letting them be seen, this trickle effect happens. It's beautiful. It's amazing. Attend things. You need to show up and be on the calls. Your people need to see your name on this screen. If you want them to do the things that you're doing, you need to do the things. Use your products in public. Let people see what you're doing. We are in a time where we are standing in lineups at the grocery store. Pull out your Thieves hand sanitizer. Start using them in front of people because we have actually more time than we realize as we're waiting to get into a lineup. So take your opportunity there. And like Gloria said, you need to be posting on social media. You want to keep a balance there, more your life than the products, but you want that. This is part of your life, but don't post stock photos and for like 10 days straight and all of a sudden your kids don't exist anymore and your life is over because all you're using is, you know, themes. So make sure that you're sharing your life as well. Have samples and give them out. When you, like I said, when you're standing in a line, if you have a few samples, that is a great way. If you have a friend card that you've made that you can get people in contact, ask if you can follow them on Instagram. Like we have a lot of time. It's just really stepping out and getting brave. It's so basic. And I think that's kind of the theme right now is how basic this is. But if you're brave in the basic stuff, it grows and it's quite amazing. And the next thing was empower. We have a lot of power with our words, with our team, and we need to be responding to all forms of communication. If people are messaging you, make sure you respond. Don't ghost people. It can be really easy to get busy and forget, but really work hard not to ghost or respond to people in comments. Even you want to just make sure that communication is two-way and that people aren't just communicating one way at you. Say for example in stories, you want to be responding back. Follow new people. This will help more people see what you're doing. Send private messages and texts. I mean, this is all stuff that just continues to build people up, is that like constant communication. And I just wanted to touch on a couple IPA type things, that just things we can be doing every day throughout the month, not just at month end, because sometimes what happens is we can save everything and then cram, and then we're exhausted. And then we get into this cycle of where we don't do anything for a long stretch because we've just crammed everything. And like Gloria said, we can do little bits every single day and it really pays off. So a few of those things is checking in your virtual office missed orders and following up sooner than later, because we can get things fixed for people that they may not realize has happened. So if an error has come up, something could be out of order, out of stock, sorry, or they could be a credit card issue and they're actually waiting for something. So just that follow up really quickly. So I actually checked my missed orders every single day and helped train my team to do that as well, so that they can follow up with their personal enrollment and kind of find out what's going on there. About to go in actives, writing people about this and what that looks like, and then explaining, those are things you don't want to ignore, those kind of one kit wonders that didn't actually get plugged in, finding creative ways to pull them back. It happens often and it's really breaks my heart when there's a number there. So just making sure that you are following up and reaching out and getting people, if it's their personal enrollment, helping them and giving them tips how to reach out, because they're going to connect with the people that they enrolled with more so, but making sure you're available to teach that. And yeah, like I said, just making sure that the promos, like the $10 credit, like all those things just stay kind of bumped up in the forefront of everyone's minds, especially for people that aren't doing this as a business. They're not thinking Young Living like we are. So we need to make sure that is bumped up. That is our job. This is what we do, is we bring this up to people's attention. So just make sure you're doing those small basic things, because over time, this is what really grows a business. That's about it. It's just really staying consistent. Like Gloria was saying, there's so many good things going to be said here today, but if we could just hammer in, it is basic, it is simple, but it takes the consistency. I hope that was helpful.
Thank you, Miranda. Hi, everyone. That was so good and so many tips. I have to say too, is that $10 credit, that is one of the things we have this month. So utilize it. It's on for the next 4 days now. So yes for, right? Yeah. And so that's an awesome thing that you can give value to your members and just reach out to them and love on them and show that you care about them, that you want them to know about this. So thank you, Miranda, for all those amazing tips. And up next, we have Tamara from Alberta. Hello, Tamara. So good to see you.
Hello. Hello, everybody. Happy New Year to everybody. Oh, everybody just take a big, deep breath. It and out with 220 or 2020. Bye. Bye, 2020. Okay. Not that it wasn't an amazing year. 2020 had some, like, there was some amazing stuff that happened in 2020, but 2021 is the year that we at least know a little bit what to expect because last year kicked us in the pants. So this year we a little bit more know what we're doing. So back to the basics. This is the foundation of how every person that is in our team got, you know, you look at like our platinums and our diamonds and our crowns and our royals, and guess how they all got there? They all got there following the same set of steps that they impart that wisdom onto us. Like, you fall, I did these steps and these are the mistakes that I made. And so instead of you also having to make those mistakes, here's a blueprint for a way that you can, if you take consistent, intentional action, you can also get successful, right? You can be successful in this. And one of the most foundational, practical steps that is laid out for us is doing classes, like 101s, 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 right? They are, 101s are how we share the products, right? And it's a little bit different now than it was, because we used to be able to gather in large groups and we could like hand around a bottle of oil and stuff like that. There's definitely a couple of things that you can do. If you have people that you are hoping to get to a class, try offering them a couple of samples that are part of the starter bundle, so that you can invite them to a class maybe 2 weeks down the road. You can get them a couple samples and then you can invite them to kind of smell a vision along with you during that class, so they're not completely missing out on smelling the oils, right? Because it's such, like, I love the like zen of the beginning of a class to like what it's like at the end of the class after everybody has smelled those 11 oils. It's like everybody's like, you know, a little bit calmer, a little bit more zen. And so to be able to offer a couple samples so that people can follow along with you at least a little bit, it allows them to actually take part in a class instead of just you know, being told about how amazing they are. They actually get to smell like lavender. And if you're super generous, you can send like 2 drops of frankincense in a bottle. So that's how we share the products. It's also how we share the community. When I do 101s, I invite like not only new people that I'm looking to join, but I also invite my existing tribe, my crossline members, my like, just anybody who wants to come, because that feeling of community is so evident on a Zoom. Like even just on this Zoom, you can see people like nodding along, agreement, and you can tell if your jokes are good or if they're falling flat, and maybe don't repeat the ones that no one laughs at. You know, like you at least get that like back and forth. You get that sense of community and the sense of I'm talking and you're listening, but also I'm looking for your feedback, because that's really like when we do classes, we're looking to make sure we're meeting their needs, not just telling them about how it works for us, right? So, you know, if you see somebody or give them the opportunity to ask questions, it's really amazing. And yeah, bring your community and get your cross line there. Everybody not, oh yeah, that's amazing. That's what I do too. There's something about that third party validation. And then it's also how we can share the opportunity in a way where you again have other people that are validating what you're saying, because oftentimes when you have crossline and stuff, you have maybe some executives or senior stars or whatever that are making a couple hundred dollars. And really in the beginning to be like, you can make $5,000 a month is a really unrealistic thing to share with people right at the beginning of the journey. But to have people who are a star and maybe, you know, had a couple of enrollments, and so their paycheck is a few hundred dollars in those first few months, or you've got a steady senior star that is making a couple hundred, or an executive that's like car payment, they're making car payments every month. That's the stuff that new people are, that they're hungry for that information, not the you can make $150,000 a month as a Royal Crown Diamond, because that feels impossible at the beginning, right? So those little things, it's a great way in classes to share the opportunity. And then like Miranda said about edifying leaders. So when I first started, I either had Gloria or Lisa, or, and that was who I invited to, like, even though I hit the ground running, like I enrolled. And when I just made the decision that I was going to share, I started doing weekly one-on-ones, sometimes two or three a week right away. Like that was just because everybody told me that that kind of consistency is what's going to pay off. That's what is going to grow you the fastest. And so I started consistently doing that, but there were still times, especially people who were on your chicken list. So does everybody know what a chicken list is? That's like the list of people that you are like, it like, whoo, makes you like, whoo, when you think about talking to them about Young Living, where you're like, oh, this, like, they don't need it. They make all the money. Their life is perfect. They're da, 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 da. All these stories that you tell yourself about how this person doesn't need Young Living, but they're all, that's just all your brain playing that nasty trick that it does with stories. And so those chicken list people, those are the people that you plug into someone else that does a really amazing 101, Lisa, Gloria, Jalene, like you look for those people, Angela, Jen Burton, like you look for those leaders that are doing like these really amazing 101s, and you plug those people that you're afraid to talk to into their 101s, because then it's not you saying it, it's someone else. So that's a really great thing. Use your leadership, you guys. That is just such a huge thing. And so classes, do them consistently. Even if you fall flat on your face, do them with your voice shaking and your knees knocking, and get on Zoom and get on Facebook Live and just do them right now more than ever. You don't have that nasty person in the room, because I've been there. I've had people literally turn their backs on me in a one-on-one and face the wall in my living room. Okay. So you don't get that on a Zoom. The worst thing that can happen is they turn their camera off. So, you know, like it's a little bit easier to fall flat on your face when you're doing this online. It's not the same like when somebody tunes out during your class, but you know, make sure that you're making them interesting and fun and lively, because that's all really important. And then the other really foundational thing that I'm going to talk to you about is essential rewards, because you everybody not being on essential rewards. So when I enroll a new member, I don't generally make it optional. I just tell them, so we're going to enroll you on this really great loyalty program. This is how we get everybody started. You're going to get these points that are like cash right away. You're going to get a promo. You're going to get a free oil right away. And you know, I've got you. So if we get to month two and this isn't working, we'll look and see how we can make this so that it works for you. But at least in the beginning, this is how we start you out, because it's the best value. Everybody loves free stuff. If you can enroll them in the first 5 days of the month, you are absolutely killing it, because not only are they getting their 10 ER points and free oil, they're getting that $10 credit. You guys, that's huge. That's just free money. Like, I don't know how anybody is not like 90% of your ER orders should be put through in the first 5 days of the month if they're in Canada, because who doesn't want free money? Like, that's just crazy. By saying no, that I don't need that $10 is like, hey universe, I don't need your extra money. You just keep it over there. I'm good over here. I don't need any abundance in my life. So first 5 days, I think that's really important. But essential rewards, I'm like the queen of point cards. Okay. Like I have like everything. Like if it has a rewards program, I am a member. Okay. Nothing ever has beaten what I get from Young Living, especially now. Like we're a couple years into our journey. We're getting 25% back on myself, 25% back on my husband. You guys, that's crazy. If I spent the money that I spend on my just daily products that we use all the time, our supplements, our cleaning supplies, our personal care items, if I spent that at a big box store, I mean, superstore, I think if you spend $250, they give you about 5 or 10% back as a one-time thing. Like it's only one time. You don't get it every month. You get it like that one time. And you don't get to go back later in the month and do it again either. Because sometimes that happens for us in Canada. So Essential Rewards, that 10% back for the first 3 months and then going to 20, that's such a huge transition and should be such a focus on getting past those first 3 months. Like, let's get you into the lifestyle in these first 3 months. You're going to get these points back. You're going to get some free stuff. And then you start getting 20% back. Show me any reward program that gives you 20% back in basically cash. It does. It's not out there. They don't exist. And then 25% back. You also get access to special collections, right? Like Thieves and Ningxia, the ER collections, they are the best way to buy those products. If you're not buying those products with those collections or helping people to buy those collections, they are totally missing out on one of the best parts about Essential Rewards, right? And there's loyalty oils. I don't know if everybody saw, Lisa did a post yesterday or the day before about what it used to be like back in the day when Lisa started this, and there were no loyalty oils. There, I think there was still the percentage back, was there, Lisa, on Essential Rewards? Yeah, so you got that, but there was no loyalty oils. There was no diffusers, which that has gone the way of the dinosaurs now. But for a long time, a lot of us were focused, you know, we use that as a focus to help drive our business, but that's a one-time thing. 20% and then 25% back is every single month, every single purchase that you make on Essential Rewards. Like it's not a one time, here you go, here's your prize, and now you're never going to get that prize again. You get this prize every single time you buy the products your family needs. Like it just is such a win. Free stuff, those collection, I mean, the amount of cool stuff that I have bought. Y'all, do you know you can get jasmine oil on ER points? That is one of our highest value oils. And if you don't have it in your collection, you need it because it's amazing. And you can get it on points. Like, oh my gosh. If I walked into Walmart and was like, I want to use my rebate. On... No. They'd be like, get out. You're from Young Living, aren't you? Yeah. Anyhow, so Essential Rewards, it is the foundation. It's where your residual income comes from. The people buying their products every month on Essential Rewards, you do the work in the beginning, you hold their hands, you guide them, you empower them to be in this lifestyle. And a year later, you're still getting paid for that effort in the beginning. Right? That is where your residual income comes from. That is the magic behind network marketing, folks. It's not running out and having to get, you know, a silver team every single month. It's having a team that understands the value of residual buying. And then as a result of that, you benefit as well as do they, right? Like they're getting all these amazing things back as well. So yeah, I think that that's all I have. Did I miss anything? No. Okay. Thanks, ladies and gentlemen.
That was so cute. I was like super distracted by the kitten that came up at the end there. I was like, there's a kitten in the house. So yeah, Essential Rewards it's literally everything. If you're not starting people on Essential Rewards, you're looking for new people every month and starting your business from scratch every month. You don't want to do that. We don't want to do that. ER is everything. And like Tamara said, it is the best for them and the best for us. So like, it's really a no-brainer. I had a girl the other day and she was like, no, I don't want to start on that. Like, I'm not into building the business. Like, I'm in healthcare and I'm so busy. And I was like, oh no, I start everybody this way because I want you to get your free oil and I want you to get your 10% back. That's literally all I said to her. And she was like, oh, okay, that makes sense. Boom, she's in. Because we're not overcomplicating, right? Back to that, like, simplicity wins. So I love how Tamara's like, I don't give them an option. Neither do I. Neither did Lisa. See? Do you see the duplication model happening before your very eyes? Because it works. So awesome. Up next, we have Janine Morris. We were chatting the other day. One of the books I highly, highly recommend if you haven't read it yet is GoPro 7 Steps to Becoming a Professional Network Marketer. I listened to that book probably like 10 times over and over in my car, because if you want to do this as like a business, you want to be professional, right? So we were chatting about it and she was like, everyone needs to read these things. So she's going to share her takeaways from the book. I see you now. Hi, Janine, how are you? I was like, I don't see her. Hello.
Hi. Thank you so much. I just got back from shopping, so I literally like just walked in the door. So, GoPro, I really, really enjoyed this book. I listen to books on Audible now because my kids are crazy under 3 and I don't have time to sit down and read. I've made it a part of my goal to read at least 10 pages a day. So I'm on that train right now. But this book I think is amazing. It's super short, which is great. Like it's, I think 3 hours max. Some of the other ones that I listened to were like 7 and I kind of like, you know, got a little lost in the middle there. But this one is so great. It literally walks you through the steps that you need to be a professional in this industry. And I think that that's something that this team really is amazing at. Our leadership is really, they're like setting goals to change the face of network marketing. Like there have been some years and everybody has a story about network marketing, right? Or their friend was involved and or whatever it is. And this team's really duplicating well, and they really do a good job of making it not so scary. Because I know when I got my kid, it was like, you know, I can't do this. I'm a stay-at-home mom. Like, how big is my network? I haven't worked in a few years. I live in a town of 600 people. So I thought in my head that there was no way that I was going to be able to do this. But things like this book, Eric Worre has been in the industry for years. Richard Bliss Brook has been in the industry for years. So following people like that and listening to what they have to say really kind of like blew my mind open, because duplication is something that, like, yes, it works, but you have to make it your own too. You like me trying to do the same presentation that Glow does or that Lisa does is not going to work, because I don't have the same kind of energy as them. I don't have the same, you know, goals as them even maybe. So duplication, it like to a point where you're teaching your team to duplicate classes and stuff is super great, but you have to make it your own. So, when I read this book, I actually like the second that it was done, I started it over because it was so amazing. And there were so many good things in it that I just don't even, I was like, I don't even know where to start. I feel like I'm so lost. But obviously like some of the major skills, finding prospects, right? So making that list is something that I didn't do in the very beginning. And I was like, whatever, because I feel like from the beginning to executive where I am now, I feel like things kind of come to you. You don't have to actively go out and find new people, because people are like, oh, what are you doing? And I'm interested. But now that I've been doing it for a couple of years, everybody in my network knows what I'm doing, and they've either said yes or no already, right? So getting out, like making that list and getting outside of the people that you know, going to different classes or joining a church if that's your thing, or, you know, a yoga group or whatever it is to get you to a bigger part of your market, and then adding to that list all the time, like the people that you know. And then when you start thinking about like your cousin, well, who do they know? And a lot of the times you're going to know a lot of those people. Like, he talks about the 6 degrees of separation. Is that, has everybody heard of that? Like, where you're connected to everybody in the world within 6 people. So adding to that list all the time is super important. And it's something that I didn't do. I still am kind of like in the middle of making my list. So, but he was saying, like, professionals keep adding to that list. And even if it's somebody who's already said no, like flat out dead no, add them to the list. If it's somebody who's like, please don't talk to me about this ever again, add them to the list, because it's not a no forever. It's a no for right now. And when they see you crushing it, they're going to be like, wait a minute, maybe I shouldn't have said no. So, and then skill number 2 is like inviting prospects and understanding your product or your, or to understand your product or opportunity. So I think a big part of that is using the products yourself. Because if you're not using them, if you are not a product of the product, like Richard Bliss Brooks says, how are you supposed to tell anybody how to use a product? So for myself, I wanted to learn everything that I could learn before I shared anything at all. And that's really, it's kind of a roadblock more than anything, because with this being a job, it's not like, so, okay, hold on. I got to look at my notes. I'm sorry. So if you want to be an expert at it, that's fine. But you have to kind of limit it during your presentations, because this is where I got hung up. I wanted to tell everybody all the things about all the things. And like, nobody is going to remember an hour of you spouting off about what Lavender does. Like, you know, so keeping it short and simple with really, really good stories. You have to learn to tell better stories, because people are not buying your product. They're buying you and your stories. So that's really big, because if you're trying to pass yourself off as an expert, they either know that you're not an expert and they get turned off by that, or they look at you and they think, there is no way that I'm going to be able to know all the things that she knows. And then your duplication is dead before it even started. Nobody's going to be able to do what you just did. So, you know, showing people how to find the resources instead of doing it for them. So this really, really hit home for me, because I am building 2 provinces away from the major part of my team. So I don't have a whole bunch of leaders to plug people into. I mean, we do now because it's all over online and stuff, but I didn't have classes to take people to. It was just me doing the things. So I held the hand of my team 100% of the time to executive. And I was like, you guys, inches away from silver last month, like this close. And December just kind of like took a major nosedive, because I had to step back and teach my team how to duplicate, because I held their hand all the way here. And I was the one booking classes. I was the one making them do stuff. And it's just, it doesn't work that way. You want to build the biggest organization you can to be self-sufficient in the shortest amount of time possible. You want your people to be doing the things that you're doing. So it doesn't pay to know everything and to be the one that they have to come to all the time. Show them where to find the information. Jen Burton, I think, is amazing at this. And when I first started, I was like, she's not helping me, but she helps you more than you even know, because she's like, this is where you find it, right? And then, so doing that for your team is going to get them up and running and understanding the things that they need to do to duplicate way more than holding their hands to the future. Like, I feel like now I'm kind of like, I'm going to just push you guys out of the nest and I got to go. Like, because I focused so much on growing them for the last 2 months that I did not have time to find my own members. And like Miranda said, you want to be signing up 2 people a month, but when I'm focusing on getting everybody else their 2 people a month, they're looking at me going like, what are you doing? Like, you're not signing anybody up, so why should I be doing the things, right? So it's pretty important. And then towards the end, he talks about the like you being a product of the 5 people you spend the most time with. And if you want to learn how to do the things, get in contact with the people that are doing the things. If you have an idea and you want some input on it, reach out to your upline, because they're not going to, like, I mean, how many people do Glow and I mean, all of you guys, how many do you have on your team? Thousands, right? Like you can't know what everybody needs all the time. So if you want something, if you want to be on a call or you want to, you know, set up an event or anything else, ask, put yourself out there and ask for it, because nothing's going to come to you if you're not out there working for it. So I used to think at the beginning, like, oh, these women must be so annoyed with me because I asked every question under the sun, like every question. How do you do this? How do you do that? Where would you start with personal development? Okay, I feel like I need this in leadership instead of in, you know, product information. So they will tell you what worked for them. They'll tell you what worked for the people that were their mentors. So this is an amazing opportunity for us to help other people. Like the world is changing. And I think all of us saw that in 2020. People who worked their whole lives in a career are no longer working in that field anymore because of what happened to our economy. So they need something. They need us right now. They need this opportunity and they need us to show them that it's not scary, that it's not a pyramid scheme, that it's not something that's a get rich quick scheme. It's a job, right? But the thing about it is that you have to perfect your duplication, because without duplication, network marketing is just another job. You're just working for everybody else. So until your people start to work the way that you do and for you, then you're spinning your wheels. You're not going to get anywhere. So I love asking my offline questions. I reach out to them all the time. Something that I think is kind of crazy and like weird is that you think when you're just starting out that they're not going to talk to you. Like, why would somebody making $20,000 a month want to talk to me? But you're such a huge part of their growth and their sustainability that they want to teach you how to do it. So listen, because they're there for you. So super great book. I'm not going to take up any more of your guys' time because I feel like I'm kind of just like flying all over the place with this. But I highly suggest like the Network Marketing Pro is super great. I'm sure that maybe some of your leaders have books or whatever that worked for them. Ask them where they got their start and where it was that they wanted to learn from, what gave them the most impact, because not everybody learns the same way. Sometimes I'm going to hear something that somebody else might not hear from a book or a podcast or whatever. So ask around, ask them all, because they're not gonna turn you away.
Oh my goodness. That was amazing. Me and Lisa were like, yes, preach. It is so true. And I just love that. If you need something, ask. And then also, I just love that, like the teaching somebody to fish versus giving them the fish. So when somebody comes to you and they're like, what oil do I use for sleep? If your reaction is, I'm going to tell you everything, what to do and how to use it and where to put it, then you maybe need to take a step back and go, I should be showing them the reference guide app that they can look at and empower them to find their own answers. Because you don't want, when you have a team of 10,000 people, and you will, if you do all these things you've heard from every single one of these amazing speakers today, and you stick to the main thing, do you want 10,000 people messaging you every day asking where to put what oil and how? That is not time freedom, my friends. You wouldn't even be able to like put a dent in those messages, right? So that's why empowering people to take care of themselves, empowering them where to find the answers, empowering them to book their own classes and to duplicate. So that was amazing. She wrote it. GoPro, 7 steps to becoming a network marketing pro. Again, I listened to that book so many times. It is filled with so many valuable nuggets. One of my favorite things is setting people up right away with the expectation that when they're starting a business, you say, I will help, comma, you will build the business, right? Like setting them up, like, this is your business. You are going to do the things. I will give you the system, but I'm not going to be there like building it for you, right? So setting people up with that expectation professionally from the beginning so that we're not trying to drag people up the mountain of success. We want people that we're linking arms with and we're all like walking together, right? Like that's the point of this. Like, so that's fun, right? Way more fun that way than like trying to have people on your back and you're like, come on, Sally, just do the things. It's like, sorry, Sally, I'm going to leave you here, but when you're ready, I'm going to come back and we're going to run up this thing together, whenever you're ready. But right now you're not ready and I just can't have you on my back. Do you get it? Okay, cool. Amazing. Up next, we have Lisa Blackstock, our shiny diamond, who is excited. All these things you heard today, like seriously, duplication works so beautifully because she taught me the things and then I turned and taught the things and we're hearing all the people say the same things. And that's because it works. Look at all of these people who are massively successful from stay-at-home moms who didn't have a big network to start with. Like anyone that's following is seeing success. So hopefully we've drilled it in enough in this call to get back to the basics. Hi, Lisa. We are so excited to hear from you.
Hi, everyone. Oh my gosh. I just love these calls. I'm so pumped up and just hearing everybody like, what? Yes, duplication is a real thing. I started off all by myself way back when, 7 years ago, and had no idea it was going to turn into this beautiful like creation of community and amazingness. So you are all just the best. So back to when I started, I just have to go back to that. And I typically do because I had no idea what I was doing. And I learned so many lessons along the way by crashing and burning and just failing forward. And one thing that I did do right was I was very consistent. And I keep asking myself, why was I so consistent and what drove me? And it was because I really, really didn't like my job and I wanted something to give me more purpose. I wanted something that I was just more than just a mom and taking care of my kids. I wanted something that gave me purpose. So when I found Young Living, it fed all of those needs in my life. And because I wanted to quit my job so badly and I saw success by having those classes, I just did not stop. I was super consistent at inviting and I was super consistent at having those classes. And I was really consistent at asking people to host classes. So all of those things led to this snowball effect and it happened quite quickly. And so I am going to tell you that the more you do in a small amount of time, the more excitement your team is going to feel, the more people are going to have belief in you. So if you do a lot quicker with a lot of energy, people are going to have more belief in you because it shows that you have belief in yourself and what you're doing. So if you can up your level of belief and you can up your level of action, it's going to be out of control and it's going to be amazing. And people are going to just be following everything you do. If we're awkward and nervous, I was a lot of that in the beginning, but I kind of just like, for those 20, half an hour, whatever, that I was doing my class, I kind of faked it. I faked that I was confident. And for me as a shy person, I had to do that. And the more action I took, the more confident I got. If you're not ready, if you don't feel ready to do something, do it anyway. Throw yourself in, jump off the cliff, get around the people who feed you belief and just fake it, just do it. And I know that might sound inauthentic, but it's not. This is for your success. This is for your long-term goal. So get that why really, really strong and wake up every day and do the things that all of these ladies have been telling you to do. And you will have success and then you will have more confidence and then you will have like, it's just a snowball thing, okay? So consistency is what builds it all. And just know ahead of time, commit ahead of time, even if there's a no-show, even if someone says no, that you're going to keep going. Commit now that even if something goes wrong, that you're still going to be here, that you're still going to be going forward, because that is what it is. It is failing forward. That's why we use that term so much, because we all fail. And that's when you know you're on the right path. And if you aren't failing, you aren't doing enough. Okay, so do more failing. And another thing, okay, so it's so simple that everyone can do this. They can all have classes. Find a running buddy. Find somebody who's going after the same goal as you and find somebody who can invite to the same classes or you can invite to theirs and bounce back and forth so that you're having 2 to 3 classes a week. Maybe between you and one other person, maybe between 3 people, but you're all inviting to the same class. And if you have people on your team, grab hold of them and get them to the front of the room with you and ask them to share the starter kits with you. Ask them to share their story. Ask them to share their wins, because that is going to edify your people and it's going to build belief in them. And then you're going to have builders. So even if they're a product user and they've shared and you're asking them what's working for you and they say, oh my gosh, Omega Drives, or oh my gosh, Sulfurzyme, or oh my gosh, Ninja Rep, then you need to get them to the class, even if they're not willing to host it with you yet, but I would push for that. Ask them to share that testimony at the end of the class, because you really want your people to hear that. You really want the audience to hear what they have to say. And it really builds that belief in them that, wow, that wasn't so bad. Next step, now you get them to the front of the room. Be like, you were so good. Oh my gosh. Okay. And another thing is what we're doing when we are having this consistency is we are building a foundation of community. And if you don't have community, you need to like have a like a big idea of what you want your community to look like, okay? Because this is your business, so you can create your culture. And what do you want that to look like? So every time you have a class, you are building a community. I didn't know I was doing that when I was having consistent classes. All of a sudden, I had these people that just wanted to keep coming back because they felt like they belonged to something. They felt like they had a purpose. They felt like they were seen, they were valued, they were appreciated. Where else do we get that in the world? Right? We get that in a community. And so when you're having those consistent classes, you're building your community. Back that up, I would say. so you're still going to keep going. Okay. I'm going to show you this. So when you know what the human needs are, then you can kind of see in a visual way. I don't know if you guys, if you go to Google, just go to Google and go human needs, and you will see this. And this is a chart that says what the human needs are. So down here, this is all just like basic food, water, breathing, health. Okay, so we answer some of that with Young Living, health, right? Some food too. and then we're moving up a level and we're going to safety. So security, employment, we have that, okay? And the next level up, we're moving into love and belonging. Where do we find love and belonging? In our community. Okay, so we're doing friendship, social interaction, affection. All of these needs as a human are getting answered by Young Living. Are you offering those things to these people? And esteem, so self-esteem, confidence, like building people up, right? Where you feel seen and heard and valued and appreciated. And at the very top, it's self-actualization. So your passion, your creativity, problem solving, where you are actually becoming the best version of yourself. We do that here. So all of these things are getting answered by Young Living. And if we bring people into the community, they're going to feel a sense of belonging and a sense of appreciation, and they're feeling seen and heard. And that is such a huge thing for people. So some tips to do that is obviously seen and heard, getting them to the front of the room, sharing their testimonies, doing the class with you. You're edifying those people and using people's names. Like when you have a shout out, when someone's doing something well, when they have a strength that you see, shout out, do a shout out, do a post about them, share what you see in them. Because when you share that belief that you see in them, that lifts people up. And that is such a huge gift that you can give to people. After they've done something really well, message them and lift them up. I think Gloria, like there are so many leaders that do that so, so well, but like help people feel seen, okay? Because that is such a gift we can give to people. And that is part of what this community is all about. And by having that consistency and having those classes, right? We are going to build a community where people feel a sense of belonging and they aren't gonna leave. They aren't gonna leave. We have products that work, right? We have Center Awards. We have these things that are foundational. A lot of other companies don't have these things where they have that 40% of people retention rate. Like, we're way above that as a diamond team. Like we're almost at the 60% mark of retention. So if you're taking care of your people and you're showing them that they have a place to belong and they're appreciated and they're valued, they will stay. So message your people, use that voice recorder, show up, show your face, and just keep loving on those people, because they will be around for a lot longer if you are valuing your people and if you're showing appreciation for them. So that is all I got for you right now. I appreciate you all. Thank you so much. And such a great call. I love you.
Oh my gosh. This call was fire. Invite all your people to watch the replay once it is up, because Seriously, these are all the things. I wanted to share before I let you go that this book also, it's called Productivity by Jill Hassan. This is the one I'm reading where I got some of my notes from today. It is freaking awesome. And I love it because it speaks to people. Maybe you get productive in the morning, maybe it's the evening. She really speaks to like the different types of people and their different learning skills of how to really like narrow things down. And it gives you such tangible advice. So if that's an area you feel like I really need to like get more clear on this and get more productive, this is a really good book. So this one, The 7 Steps to Becoming a Network Marketing Professional, GoPro, is amazing. Secrets of the Millionaire Mind by T. Harv Eker. If you struggle with money, money blocks, that's a really good one. If you struggle with worth, Samantha Skelly, Hungry for Happiness is a good one for worth. So if any of those areas you're like, I need a little bit more in that, go and do the personal development, you guys, because it's like, seriously, it's feet in the dirt, all the steps you heard today, and head in the clouds. Learning and learning from people who like inspire us and keep us like wanting to keep reaching for new heights. Okay. Feet in the dirt, head in the clouds. We love you all. Have an amazing rest of your weekend. This call. So, so, so good. I will post the books in the event. Okay. We'll talk to you guys later. Bye guys. So good to see your faces. Who's fired up? I'm fired up. Okay. Woo! Bye everybody.